Hi, I'm Alan Weckel from 650 Group Market Research, and I'm happy today to be here to talk about OFC 2021. And I was thinking about this before we get into kind of highlights of the year, OFC is an important show because without the technology that we've seen in the show throughout the last decade, we wouldn't really be able to be working from home, and we wouldn't really be able to have a virtual conference. So it's kind of exciting to be part of a trade show that truly impacts our lives every day and enables conferences like this virtually and the ability for all of us to work from home. So as we look at 2021 and OFC, it will be June 6th through June 11th of this year. And there's going to be a lot of interesting announcements this year. We're really starting to begin the 400 gig upgrade cycle and what that means for inside the data center, as well as what that means for DCI, kind of the ZR plus conversation. And we've had a lot of exciting announcements there, whether that's Acacia ending up at Cisco or Inphi ending up at Marvell. We've had major M&A, and we're about to get major shipment volumes as we enter the second half of the year. So all these announcements that we've seen through the previous couple years are gonna come to fruition in production traffic. And what that enables is more content, more applications at the edge, and kind of an increase there in bandwidth and our everyday lives in terms of the applications we use and the services that we rely on more and more each and every day. When we kind of think about the show and what we're excited to see, there's a lot of really good workshops out there related to co-packaging and photonics that we're going to be attending. And we're kind of excited in the virtual format not to be running up and down the hallways to get to all the events out there. And we're also seeing some really exciting announcements on what's beyond 400 gig, right? So we spent the last couple of years talking about the 56 gig SerDes, 112 gig SerDes, and now we're talking about the 224 gig SerDes. So how do we enable 800 gig and how do we enable 1.6 terabit? And what does that mean for the ecosystem, right? We've had very exciting announcements from Broadcom in terms of what's going on from an ASIC point of view, as well as what's going on from a silicon photonics point of view. Same thing for Intel and, as we mentioned, Acacia and Inphi. And what that kind of leads to is more bandwidth and more ability to connect devices, whether that's the wave of IoT devices we're seeing out there or the wave of 5G devices we're seeing, kind of that concept of edge computing. All these technologies that we see at OFC, whether it's in the workshops or sort of the booths or talking to people, are going to be there. And in this virtual environment, we're really going to see the same flavor that we've got to see and enjoy so much in person. We're seeing a bunch of multinational companies there from across the globe participating, discussing everything from cutting edge technology, whether that's at the SerDes or IP level, all the way up to the full system level. Like, how do we connect all these devices and what does that mean? And when we think about it from a market point of view, some of this is just an improvement in technologies, but a lot of this is new TAM. It's brand new opportunity, whether that's revenue or applications that never existed before. I think ZR is a great example of that. It's this new technology out there that not only enables a higher speed at a lower cost compared to anything we've been able to see in the past, but it also is brand new connections. We're talking about connecting facilities and locations that were cost prohibitive in the past. And that allows better connectivity for all users or all people in a location that, again, we just couldn't have in the past due to bandwidth. And that's looking like that's going to be, in and of itself, a multi-billion dollar opportunity that is, again, a greenfield for everybody. So a lot of vendor excitement there and not just talking about new speeds and feeds. When we look at the show, and I've been going for over 10 years and are just as excited this year as I have been in the past going in person, we're seeing a tremendous amount of technology out there. And to me, that's really impressive. We've all been kind of stuck at home and working from home, but we've been able to increase, to a certain extent, keep innovation velocity out there. And we see that in some of the announcements. We're seeing a lot of ZR and ZR Plus pluggables. We're seeing the beginnings of announcements in 400 gig, moving to 800 gig and even some talk about 1.6 terabit out there. And a lot of technologies are coming together to enable that. So we're starting to see the beginning of, I'd say, production silicon photonics, as well as kind of co-packaging out there. And that's going to enable a brand new class of compute and a brand new class of applications. So if you remember where we were, say, 5 or 10 years ago, we had several apps on our phone. Now we have the ability to order an Uber or a Lyft. We have the ability to order food. And just like everything occurs on that phone. And it's really due to these technologies that are connecting data centers together and sort of enabling that technology. And as I look kind of at a preview, which you're all going to be able to see at OFC, but I have a little bit of advantage to see some of that ahead of time, we really have the spirit of innovation going. And there's just so many announcements out there, and it's really exciting. And we're kind of going down the list of, we're say, kind of traditional OFC players like Infinera and Ciena, and what they're doing and sort of the technologies they're driving there in terms of the interconnect, whether that be long haul or metro. And then sort of seeing what's happening with Cisco with Acacia and Inphi with Marvell and what Broadcom and Intel are doing. We're seeing just a tremendous amount of innovation there. And the list of companies as we go through is really impressive and long. So what that means is we're really well poised for a great OFC 2021. And we're also well poised for this technology to keep driving forward and enabling not only the applications that we rely on today, but also these new applications that are either on the top of people's minds or are going to be invented that are really going to create a tremendous amount of opportunity and change and innovation over the next couple of years. So I look forward to seeing you there virtually, and hopefully next year we'll be able to see each other in person once again. Thanks for spending the time with me on the video today.